Hey, mathematicians, it's Justin again, and welcome back to Ren and Mia's Lemonade Stand. In our last lesson, we learned about factors by organizing supplies, like cups and pitchers, into equal groups. Well, there's one more item left to organize, the straws. Ren and Mia bought 50 in total, but 17 of them are curly, silly straws. They want to figure out all the ways they can sort 17 silly straws into equal groups. How many ways can we group them evenly? I know one group of 17 straws will work, since 1 and the number itself are always factors, but are there any other ways to arrange them? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to determine whether a number is prime or composite, and use divisibility rules to identify factors of numbers up to 100. Have your guide and notes ready, and let's sort these straws. We already know one group of 17 silly straws works, so 1 and 17 are factors of 17. They're the whole numbers we can multiply to equal another number. Does 17 have any other factors? Let's test it out. Is 2 a factor of 17? For 2 to be a factor, the number has to be even. And since 17 is odd, 2 is not a factor. How about 3? Let's count. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. Since 17 isn't in that list, 3 is not a factor. Okay, what about 4, 5, or 6? Are any of these factors of 17? List the first few multiples of each to find out. Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. What do you notice about these multiples of 4 and 6? They're all even, so 4 and 6 can't be factors of 17. And what does a number need to end in to have 5 as a factor? 0 or 5, right. So 5 isn't a factor either. And based on our multiplication facts, 7, 8, 9, and 10 aren't factors either. It turns out 17 only has 2 factors, 1 and itself. That means 17 is a prime number, a number with exactly 2 different factors, 1 and itself. Since we have a prime number of silly straws, we can organize them as one group of 17 or 17 groups of 1, but that's it. What about the other 33 standard straws? How can we organize those? Pause here to record all the factors of 33 in your guided notes. So 1 and 33 are factors, but are there any others? 33 is odd, so 2 isn't a factor, but 3 times 11 equals 33, so 3 and 11 are factors. When a number has more than 2 factors, it's a composite number. Since 33 is a composite number with more factors than just 1 and itself, we have more ways to organize those straws. But what if we have a bigger number, like 72, 87, or 97? How can we figure out if they're prime or composite? Instead of guessing or testing every number, we can use divisibility rules to help us quickly check for factors. You actually know a few already. What needs to be true for a number to have 2 as a factor? The number needs to be even. If a number ends in 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8, it'll have 2 as a factor. So is 2 a factor of 72? Yeah, it's even. That means 72 is divisible by 2, because it can be split into 2 equal groups without any leftovers. Is 87 divisible by 2? Nope, 87 is odd, so 2 is not a factor. And 97? Also odd. 2 is only a factor of 72 in this list. But we know something more than we did before. Since 2 is also a factor of 72, does that make it prime or composite? Since it has more than two factors, 72 is a composite number. You also know the divisibility rules for 5 and 10. What does a number need to end in for it to have 5 as a factor and to have 10 as a factor? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. Numbers that end in 0 or 5 will always have 5 as a factor. And numbers ending in 0 will have 10 as a factor. These rules help us quickly check if numbers are divisible by 5 or 10 to find potential factors. For example, are 5 or 10 factors of 72, 87, or 97? None of them end in 5 or 0, so they aren't divisible by 5 or 10. That means 5 and 10 aren't factors of these numbers. 3s, 4s, and 6s also have divisibility rules. To test if 3 is a factor, we can add the digits of the number. If 3 is a factor of that sum, then 3 is also a factor of that number. Here's an example. With 72, adding the digit 7 and the digit 2 equals 9. And since 3 is a factor of 9, 3 is also a factor of 72. We can check this by skip counting. 3 times 10 is 30, so 3 times 20 equals 60. Skip counting by threes from there takes us to 63, 66, 69, 72. 72 is divisible by 3. Pause here to figure out if 87 and 97 are divisible by 3 in your guided notes. Adding the digits 8 and 7 equals 15. And since 3 is a factor of 15, 3 is also a factor of 87. It can be split into 3 equal groups without anything left over, so 87 is divisible by 3. But 97's digits add up to 16. 3 is not a factor of 16, so 3 is not a factor of 97. Since 3 times 30 equals 90, another way we could find this out is by counting up from 90. 93, 96, 99. 97 isn't in that list, so 97 is not divisible by 3. So we know 72 and 87 are composite because they have more than two factors. Since we haven't found any other factors of 97, is it prime? Let's check a few more factors to be sure. For a number to have 4 as a factor, it needs to be even and divisible by 2 twice. 97 is odd, so 4 is not a factor. For a number to have 6 as a factor, it needs to be divisible by both 2 and 3. We already know 97 isn't divisible by either, so 6 can't be a factor. For 7, we can jump up to 7 times 12, which is 84, and then skip count on from there. 91, 98. Nope, 7 isn't a factor of 97. Pause here to figure out if 8 or 9 are factors of 97 in your guided notes. Just like with 2, a number needs to be even to have 8 as a factor. And since 97 is odd, 8 is not a factor. As for 9, 9 times 10 equals 90. And 9 times 11 equals 99, so 9 isn't a factor either. If you've checked for factors up through 10, you'll have found all of the factors for any number up to 100, and you can tell whether it's prime or composite. Since 97 still only has 1 and 97 as factors, it's prime. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that we'll just keep this group of 17 silly straws in one container? Now you know that a prime number has exactly two different factors, one and itself, while a composite number has more than two factors. Divisibility rules help you quickly check if one number is a factor of another to determine whether a number is prime or composite. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with prime and composite numbers. This lemonade stand is ready for business. We'll check in on Ren and Mia's sales in our next lesson. Remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.